you knew in Alaska at night they were toasted too.
Be there one and all.
Guys have had a good time, man, because you guys look fantastic out there. For those of you who may have forgotten or weren't here in the beginning, we're Kings of Leon. God bless you all. Greyhound station, the Chester boys are going down. On everything that the mama believes, a pack of smokes and a little bump of cocaine help you feel not so strange. I said, oh, Pa, she don't get on. She'll shy once if she crossed the line and's all tied to a chair. I was laying on the ground, blowing white noise, sound like a train of tears. Chances are that worm in his lap don't even know which fish he like to bite tonight. Oh, tonight, tonight, tonight. Oh, maybe tonight. I slow Paul, she don't get on. Live somebody. She'll shine once if she's crossing the line. Things all tied to a chair. I stay on the ground, blowing white noise. Sound like a train of tears.
Ah! Hello, 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 Kings of Leon, hello. Three quarters, hello, hello. How you doing, Jared, Caleb, Nath? Nice to see you guys. How are you?
Good to see you.
Pretty fresh off the stage, I'd say. How long? Minutes? Literally?
Half a beer.
Half a beer, good.
Yeah. So that's not long at all, then.
Well, you guys, that's about 60 seconds.
Can I speak up on behalf of the viewers at home who can't smell this? You smell great.
Someone's
wearing
a smelly.
You're the best smelling band I've had all weekend.
Is that cool
water? Who is that?
Is that cool water?
I think it's all of us.
Is it cool water?
I don't have any on.
They all smell pretty good to me.
They smell good. It's the body wash.
Yeah.
It's the lanolin?
Just innate.
The soap at the Holiday Inn Express is amazing. Amazing.
Speaking of amazing, your show, what we saw, I mean, I went side of stage for a second, just down like on the side of the pit, and I could only gauge it from the crowd reaction. It looked incredible. For you guys on stage, just a few words about today.
It was great. We tried to change the setup a little bit. We just wanted to rock. We've been watching Queens of the Stone Age like every night, and they've been blowing our mind.
I heard you put a little emphasis in the black thumbnail at the top of the set. That came in with a bit of grunt, didn't it?
Yeah. Yeah. We've been doing our best. Since I cut my hair, everyone thinks that I'm like Samson and I can't
lose
rock
the strength,
anymore.
Lose the strength. But, yeah.
Nah. So you're just kind of going twice as hard at it to prove the point. Nah.
Yeah. We have a contest now, like a star system, and we let the crew vote on who rocked the hardest.
Oh, I like that idea.
And this afternoon, this evening?
Landslide.
I won today.
Landslide. It was all me, Jared Falwell.
All right, you're
going
to have to let the road. Super Dave's going to have to decide
Super
that
Dave
one,
is going to have to say Super Dave roadie to all bands, spiritually and physically.
Yeah.
And, you know, Oxygen as well. You'd been doing a few festivals. So, I mean, how's it feeling for you this summer? People are obviously getting the new stuff, and you got three albums to play now, so you're trying to change it up every night. You talked about breaking the set up. You're trying to keep it different each night.
Yeah, we you know, we judge the crowd and we'll take songs out of the set or put ones in. Just taking some risks now. You know, we've been doing this for so long. We've been away from home for so long. We have to keep it interesting. So yeah, we're just really playing for ourselves up there.
It must be kind of cool to come back to the UK because, you know, from our perspective, we had a little break where you kind of weren't around, you know, and then you brought this album back this year and instantly it was just like this euphoric kind of reception. But it needn't necessarily have gone that way. I mean, you never know, do you? Were you kind of nervous about that when you brought the new record out, or did you just know it was going to be fantastic?
We knew it would definitely be number one for at least 1 week. Maybe two. We didn't know it was going
to
be two.
Dude, I went to Nobu on the second week.
Did you?
I celebrated for you.
Wow.
Yeah, rock shrimp on me. Everybody.
That's awesome.
Nah, there's, you know, there's always a little pressure because this is where we kind of broke and the first place where we were like,
yeah.
Well, we
you
thought
know,
it was much
discovered.
Better. You know, we thought it was the best record we had done, and we kind of imagined that the reviews would be better just because we thought that we had done a better job on all aspects of the recording and the songwriting. So.
But also, just speaking from a fan's perspective, as soon as I heard the new record, the playing was so much more confident and more aggressive. Everybody stepped up from the drumming, say, you know, right through to the soloing. Matthew's playing, everyone's playing. So when it comes to performing that live every night, I'd imagine it requires a lot more exertion than perhaps
the first two. Well, actually, the musicians that we hired to do the record for us, it's kind of hard to...
Yeah, to
it's an exclusive on BBC Three. All those rumors are absolutely false.
I think that's known as the Steely Dan complex, where you can't actually play your own records in it. Right, okay, what's going on? What did this guy do for that solo? So what's next for you, kind of after this summer, after the festival season's over? Are you still going to be out on the road, or are you planning something else?
We haven't started in America yet. Yeah. We have a big arena tour in America coming up here pretty soon.
We have 2 weeks off this year.
Yeah, no way. Which 2 weeks? What are you going to do?
Next week in Spain.
Fantastic. Good
and
choice.
Then we got to fly to Japan from Spain to play AFS, which sucks.
Right.
But I mean, we love Japan. We love our Japanese
Get
fans.
That in there quickly.
Good safe. Yeah. But the ranch is all good? Is people looking after the ranch back home?
Yeah. Our cousin
Jared is taking care of the ranch for us.
Excellent.
Yeah.
Thank God for him.
Brother.
Between him and Super Dave, it's all sewn up.
You guys
it's all
are
gonna
fine.
Be
You're in good hands. Right, now we're gone.
The other day, I forget where we were, but I was watching, I guess it was this.
Yeah.
And you had Arctic Monkeys and Lily Allen.
We did.
She was wasted.
She
had had a few.
Yeah, she was slightly more than half a beer off stage, but she was enjoying herself, which is the main thing.
I was just sitting there like, I was in my hotel room. I was like,
Caleb,
wow.
I was just sitting there going.
Yeah, we both were. I mean, if you missed that at home, you might have press red. I would imagine that'll be on the best bits of the weekend.
Do her a favor, actually,
right?
And don't.
Yeah, I would. I'll go online, go to the website.
She get a breathalyzer. For every band that you interviewed,
we did it melted.
See just
she did the same thing on the side stage for Queens of the Stone Age. I was standing there with Alex from Arctic, and she was ridiculous, like falling over, and people were just kind of catching her.
She's a rock and roller. That's and what we do, and that's the glory of the British woman.
We are saying it again. She needs to get off the road.
Yeah, she's a poppin' solar, not a rock and roller.
We are picking a fight with Lily Allen.
I wouldn't. She'll take you. She'll take you down.
Mama, don't take no mess, boys. Watch out.
I could take her and Amy Winehouse out with one windmill.
And on that note, let's check out Kings of Leon right now. One of the highlights of your set. Thanks for dropping by, guys. Have a great time, and we're going to watch Encore right now. Thanks a lot.
Cheers.
More beer.